Good morning. On December 27th, Enon UMC online and at home, we just thought, you know, I hope you have a wonderful Christmas. And as we're thinking about Christmas, Christmas isn't over because there's 12 days of Christmas. So you may have already thrown out your tree and packed up your decorations, but actually, we should continue celebrating until January 6th, which is the coming of the wise men known on the church calendar as Epiphany. And so we're still in this Christmas space. And I was thinking about sitting around the piano and singing Christmas songs and asking you just to join in those familiar carols. And we're not going to hit all of them, unfortunately, but we'll hit a few of them. And we just invite you to join along and just celebrate. Go grab a cup of hot chocolate or coffee or tea or something warm to drink so that you can just kind of snuggle up, sing Christmas songs, and continue that celebration of Jesus' birth and the fact that he came, the fact that he loves us so very much. So what an awesome thing that is. And so as we kind of just get our hearts in the right space, in Psalm 98 it says, "Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth into joyous song and sing praises. Sing praises to the Lord with the lyre and the sound of melody, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Make a joyful noise before the King of the Lord." Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Come, O Lord, in thy name.
let's go into a time of prayer this morning as we just celebrate the birth of Jesus, as we give thanks for our provisions, as we turn our hearts to the Lord and just surrender all that's inside. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you so much that you came. We thank you so much for glorious songs that we can sing to you. We thank you for the angels that sang, the angels that foretold what was going to happen, the angels that proclaimed that you were born, the angels that shared with Mary the miracle that was to come. Lord God, we thank you so much. We thank you for Christmas. We thank you for the promises that it brings. And Lord, we are mindful that there are those that this season really is hard for. They maybe have lost a loved one during this season, or they're just struggling and it's not easy. But you came to this world to bring hope, to bring promise, to bring love and exceeding joy. You came to bring change to the world. You indeed are the light of the world. And so wherever we are this morning, we can have hope in you. We can turn to you and ask you to walk our journeys with us. We can turn to you and ask you to comfort us. Ask you that to make your love known to us so that we don't feel alone, so that the brokenness begins to mend. That in the brokenness there is light. Jesus, we thank you that we can call on your name, that we can call on your holy name. We just praise you this morning. And we surrender ourselves to you. We surrender our thoughts to you, our concerns to you, Lord God. There are many concerns that we want to lift up. We want to lift up those that are still struggling with this crazy virus all over the globe. But God, we just want it knocked down. We pray for those that have worked hard to create a vaccine. We pray for its success. We pray for your hand upon it against adverse reactions to it. We just pray, Lord, that this will calm this virus and will eventually defeat it. We know, Lord, in one breath you can defeat it. We continue to call on your most holy name. To move those mountains, to move mountains where our nation is so divided, where there's corruption and evilness. But God, you came to bring light into this darkness. May that light shine so many places that the darkness is snuffed out. We praise you, God. We just give you praise. And we take a few minutes, Lord, just to pause as we surrender our hearts to you. Up with our Christmas decorations until the next season. May we keep you in the forefront of our very lives, to guide us, to direct us, to hold on to. For we need to be about the light, not the darkness. Help us to be light bearers, Lord Jesus. We praise your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you. tells a story, the story of Jesus, his birth, the fact that he came to die on a cross for us, to give us life, to give us that salvation that we desperately need. It is just a praise. And so I hope that that spoke to you too, the Christmas hallelujah. This morning, we're going to go backwards just a little bit because we want to talk about some things that we learned from the angels. And so I invite you to be present in the Gospel of Luke 2. Hear these words.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words, and pondering what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom there will be no end."
Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her, who was said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Week, but anyway, the angels did a lot to bring special things. And the angel of Gabriel brought seven different things to Mary. He told her seven different things. He told her that she would become pregnant. He came bearing that news, that she would give birth. And he told her that the name of the baby would be Jesus. And he would be great. He would be the Son of the Most High. And so The angel Gabriel informed Mary that you're going to give birth to the Son of God, to the Son of God, that he will be given the throne of David, and that he will rule Jacob's house forever. There will be no end to his kingdom. Just think, in that short amount of time, at least according to the word that we read, all these things were told to Mary. All these things were told. That she is going to conceive by the Holy Spirit, a miraculous happening is going to happen. God is going to enter. Something miraculous is going to happen. And then we see from that space how he tells her, this isn't just going to be a baby, this is the Son of God, the Son of the Most High. He will be great. His kingdom will last forever. We need to hear those words too. Because Jesus isn't one that we pack up and get out at seasons. Jesus is one that came to change the world and to change our personal lives, to change us. Jesus came. The angel shares the news, and the angel shared all sorts of news. The angels did over that season. The angel spoke to Joseph, and Joseph knows. And so the angel tells. Now Mary's young, but what we hear from Mary, the words that we hear, we talked about some of them when we talked about joy, what we hear from Mary is a person with a servant's heart. She loves the Lord. She desires to please the Lord. She desires to do what God asks. So she's not a slacker. She listens for God's direction, because she wants to please him, not just herself. You know, that's a key element as well. Because if we look at this story and we see what the angels have said, what the promises have been, even tell the shepherds, don't be afraid. I bring you good news. I bring you good tidings. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. And to Mary, they come and they encourage her too. Gabriel encourages, don't be afraid. I have this news to tell you. Brings news, but then foretells who Jesus is going to be. The Messiah is coming. This is who he is. Powerful news. And then we see with Mary her servant's heart, and that's the heart we need to have. Not one that's about us and about pleasing ourselves, but one that is about pleasing God first and being available to help others. Servant's heart. Jesus showed that before he gave his life on the cross by washing feet of the disciples. Their feet were dirty and dusty. The ground is dirty and dusty. That's how it is. If you go to visit Israel, your shoes are all dusty. Your feet get dusty. They wore sandals. Their feet were dirty. Jesus took off his robe and got a cloth and washed the disciples' feet. The most humble of acts. Humility. And we see that in his mother Mary, that she doesn't want to please herself. She wants to please God. She has a servant's heart. And she listened for the direction from God. We aren't always good about waiting and listening for what the direction the Lord may tell us. There's a direction that can be spoken to each one of us if we take time to listen and if we seek. Remember about the digging our roots deep into God's love? We still need to do that. And we need to listen for the direction that we are given by the Lord. Not only did God's angel announce Jesus' birth to the shepherds, but there were angelic voices that praised God. So if the angels are praising God, we surely should be praising God. We should surely be praising the Lord on a regular basis. Angels, the heavenly beings, are praising God. He is holy. He deserves our praises. Glory to God in the heavenly heights. Peace to all men and women on earth who please him. So we learn these things from the angels. We learn these things in this story of being, of humility. We learn things of faithfulness as Joseph listens and is faithful to be true to Mary, even though what an extraordinary thing that has happened. But he stays by her. He stays by her side. They journey a long ways to get to Bethlehem from Nazareth. The road wasn't easy. It was hard. The journey was hard. And as we've talked about before, they journey all this way and then they get there and there's no room for them to stay. Jesus could have come and he could have been born in a palace. He could have come and been born in the best house in the town. But he came and was born in a stable, in a manger. It's a pretty awesome story. And the angels, in their messages, and they're speaking, and they're bringing peace, and they're singing, played a huge part in this story, a huge part in the journey. Gives us all the more reason to just want to sing praises to God and to sing these carols and remembering that this isn't the end of Christmas. It wasn't one day. It's 12 days of Christmas. I think that's just good news. We can sing carols and Christmas songs and dig into the Word of God. Read Luke if you haven't done it yet. Now's a good time. You have 12 days to read the book of Luke. Just take that time and that meditation and look what happened. Look what God did. God sent his son. Heavenly beings show us the way as they sing. And they tell us, glory to God in the heavenly heights. Peace to all men and women on earth who please him. Mary's desire was to please God. Mary's desire was to please God. I hope our desire is to please God as well, that we put the Lord first, that we want to please him. That's all part of that fruit of the Spirit. We bear fruit of the Spirit as we dig our roots deep. We bear that fruit of love and joy and peace and kindness and gentleness and faithfulness and all of those things, self-control. I hope that this Christmas season has been, even though it's so different, that you find it's been truly special in your hearts. Let us pray. Dear Lord God, we thank you for coming. We thank you for the example we hear in the angels, for their encouragement of not being afraid, for their leadership in their singing of praises to you because they know who you are. For Mary, who was willing to be a servant, to please you, not to please herself. We thank you for Jesus, who came to change this world, who's still here to change the world, to be the light in the world. And Lord God, we need that light. We need that light. May it shine brighter from each one of us. May we be your ambassadors, willing to shine your light into this world. We praise you and we just give you all honor and glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
for the day. So now as you go from wherever you are, go with that joy in your heart, that joy that Jesus came to bring. Go feeling the love of Jesus wrapped around you with that warmth and that presence that says, you are not alone, I am with you. God is with you, Emmanuel. Emmanuel. God is with you, God is with us. And go be light bearers to this world that needs to hear the good news. We have a Savior, a Messiah, who came to change the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.